Madam Chair, thank you for giving me the floor. I would like to thank Ms. Martha Helena Lopez, Assistant Secretary General for Human Resources Management, and Mr. Carlos Ruiz Meshu, SCBQ Chair, for their respective reports and presentations today morning. Madam Chair, we welcome Secretary General's Global Human Resource Strategy presented in continuation of his management reform proposals, which we have supported. We hope that the strategy will be able to address a range of persisting challenges, including the long elusive goal of equitable geographical representation. Secretary General's system-wide strategy on gender parity, especially in senior management, and the related strategy to eliminate sexual exploitation and abuse and sexual harassment in the workplace are meeting success. We hope that the human resource strategy would help consolidating these gains and sustain the approach. Madam Chair, the UN Charter puts equitable geographical representation at the heart of human resources management. However, challenges continue to persist. Out of a total of UN Secretariat staff of 38,000 people, less than 10% are covered by the system of desirable ranges. Even for these 3,600 posts, 64 countries are listed as underrepresented and unrepresented. 50 of these 64 countries are developing countries. The number of member states in the category of unrepresented or underrepresented continues to increase since 2014. In addition, nearly 60 more developing countries are close to the lower level of their desirable range of representation and remain at the risk of slipping into the underrepresented category. These numbers paint a very stark picture of the current inequitable representation. Currently, a member state's assessed rate of contribution to the UN's regular budget has an overwhelming influence on determining the desirable range for staff representation. This inherently puts developing economies at a serious disadvantage. These formulae may need to be revisited. We have an opportunity this year to reform the system. Secretary General has presented several options to reform the system. We hope that a consensus would emerge to expand the base figure of posts under the desirable range system, as well as to address the current imbalance in the weightage of the three factors. The suggestion regarding the inclusion of troops and police contribution for UN peacekeeping needs to be looked at seriously. Sustained and significant contribution in this regard should be added to the formula. With regard to the posts funded from peacekeeping support account also, the representation of major troop and police contributing countries is far from adequate. Madam Chair, increasing regional diversity of all the UN Secretariat international staff is also identified as one of the strategic action by the Secretary General in his global resource strategy. Regional disparity remains especially stark at senior level positions. If we look at the peacekeeping leadership positions, nearly half of the force commanders, 6 out of 14, are from Wyog, comprising only 14% of the total member states. At a broader level, if we look at the staff composition of all the UN departments and offices, as per the data made available in the Secretary General's report, the Asia-Pacific group with 53 member states, 27% of all member states, and more than half of global population constitute only around 17% of the UN Secretariat international staff. The reason for this disparity needs to be looked into carefully to consider ameliorative measures. Madam Chair, we take note of the concept of regional diversity as a broad indicator of disparity levels. However, we caution that overemphasis on this concept may divert our focus away from the actual goal of equitable geographical representation. An effective solution to all these concerns is the reform of the current system of desirable ranges. Madam Chair, we assure you of our constructive engagement on all these issues. I thank